Because it is Monday night, which means you survived another Monday morning, you get a treat.
We fly with our own wings, care about the same things. We stand strong together, so let me hear you sing. We fly with our own wings, dreaming all the big dreams. Long live Oregonians, we're free to be healthy. Long live Oregonians, we're free to be healthy.
That colorful, harmonic, sort of trippy retro ad was created by the state of Oregon, obviously, as a way to promote the thing that you saw right there at the very end of the PSA. Cover Oregon, the official state health insurance exchange created under our new national health reform law. Cover Oregon was supposed to launch October 1st, along with the new national exchange. But like the federal exchange, Oregon's system had some technical difficulties, so they decided not to open the site yet. People can still prep their applications for health insurance, but their applications will be processed by hand instead of online for the time being until the online system has worked out the kinks. Even with those technical glitches, though, something sort of amazing has happened in Oregon. Since October 1st, so in just the last 3 weeks, Oregon has managed to sign up so many people for health insurance that they have cut the total number of people who don't have health insurance in the state by 10% already. Look at that headline. In the span of the first 2 weeks, actually, the number of uninsured people in Oregon dropped by 10% in total, thanks to Obamacare. And that is even without the exchange opening up. That's because the other part of Obamacare is the expansion of the existing health insurance program for low-income families, which we've had for decades. They expanded the criteria for who can qualify to get health insurance from that program, from Medicaid. And in so doing, Oregon officials have signed up tens of thousands of people in the state who were uninsured before Obamacare went into effect.
In states where governors and legislatures have wisely allowed it, the Affordable Care Act provides the opportunity for many Americans to get covered under Medicaid for the first time. So in Oregon, for example, that's helped cut the number of uninsured people by 10% just in the last 3 weeks. Think about that. That's 56,000 more Americans who now have health care.
The original Affordable Care Act, when it passed Congress, mandated that all states would have to do what Oregon did. They would all have to expand the eligibility rules for people to get health insurance through the Medicaid program. But when the health reform law went before the Supreme Court last year, the court overall upheld the constitutionality of the law. But they did change part of it. They changed it so the Medicaid thing in the states is now optional instead of mandatory. So because of the Supreme Court ruling, states can opt out of expanding their Medicaid programs to cover more people. 22 states have either opted out or are leaning toward opting out already. This number is still fluid. It continues to change. For instance, Ohio today moved toward saying yes to expanding Medicaid. But at this point, there are 22 states that are moving toward opting out. And yes, those 22 states are mainly states with Republican governors. And so now, even just a few weeks into the start of implementation of this new national project, we're starting to get really vastly unequal outcomes and unequal progress among the 50 states. There is no single story to tell about how reforming healthcare in America is going so far. There's a lot of different smaller stories. The right, of course, is hoping for just broad brush failure.
Average Americans, their families, were also feeling the pain thanks to the healthcare overhaul train wreck. And six of them, they're here with us tonight to tell their story, which, by the way, the media ignores.
That's a man named Sean Hannity, who hosts a television program on the Fox News Channel, which is across the street from us. Mr. Hannity recently interviewed three families who he said have been suffering with the boot of Obamacare on their necks. That's the narrative on the right now. Obamacare is the end of liberty. Obamacare is destroying America. Salon.com recently published a fact check of those Obamacare horror stories that were aired on Fox News. A former staffer to Montana Governor Brian Schweitzer, Eric Stern, who was on All In tonight, he decided to track down each of the Hannity Show's guests who said Obamacare was ruining their lives. One guest said that Obamacare was destroying his construction business. He was firing employees. Well, he may be firing employees, but it's not because of Obamacare, since his business is small enough that nothing in the new law applies to his business at all. Another guest said her health insurance plan was being terminated because of Obamacare. true, as it turns out, but that's because her plan was overcharging her. And now she can spend less money to get a plan that covers everything that used to be covered, plus more. Isn't that terrible? Same goes for the third couple that appeared on that show on Friday night. They told the Fox News audience that their existing health insurance plan was also canceled. They said they think they are now facing a 75% rate increase. Actually, turns out they can get a plan that covers what their old plan covered for much cheaper. It's on the Obamacare exchange. The reason that couple does not know it's on the Obamacare exchange is because they refuse to look at the exchange. They say they're opposed to shopping there on principle, and so they will not look. So, awkward cable TV segment. But the right has their narrative, and they're sticking to it. Off TV and back in policy land, the states and the federal government are plugging along with varying degrees of success. This past weekend, the federal health insurance exchange was taken down for more maintenance. President Obama at that Rose Garden event today said the administration was mounting a tech surge to make the site work better. This week, Republicans in Congress are planning to hold oversight hearings about how terrible and horrible it's all gone so far, even while efforts continue to fix what's wrong and press on with the rollout. So who knows how it's all going to shake out politically, who gets the credit and who gets the blame. But in the meantime, brass tacks, 56,000 non-hypothetical real people in Oregon who didn't have health insurance last month have it now. Right next door to Oregon, the state of Washington, they're crowing now about how, if you look at Oregon compared to them, Oregon's a failure compared to them in Washington State. In Washington State, they've got their online exchange open, and they've already signed up more than 60,000 people. And again, most of them are from the Medicaid expansion, but tens of thousands of those new signups are due to the Obamacare exchanges. We are seeing this work in some places, and it is going to take a while, and it is falling into place at different rates and different ways, depending in part on whether or not your Republican governor wants to run for president. But that is what is coming into focus more than anything. It's a patchwork of unequal outcomes. In some places it's working, in some places it is not working yet, but it's gonna work, and in some places they are doing their damnedest to make sure that it does not work no matter what, not ever if they can help it. The consequences of that being the patchwork of outcomes in our nation, I think, are hard to foresee at this point. Certainly the outcome for that politically is very, very hard to see. But these outcomes are beyond just politics, and they may be beyond just healthcare. I mean, we dramatize everything in politics by saying that everything is life and death, right? We overuse that idea. But whether or not you can access healthcare can be a life and death thing. And even when it is not a life and death thing, it is certainly a matter of thousands of dollars for your family, year after year after year, for regular everyday families, no matter how your family votes. I mean, if these differences in outcomes persist in a way that has a real material effect on people's lives, forget the politics. Should we expect migration? Shouldn't we expect that people might move from states where you really can't get good health coverage for your family to places where you can get that coverage? It would have a huge material effect on your life if these differences between the states are sustained over time. This is a work in progress, but right now, if you are in a red state without good health coverage, you probably still are screwed now and for the foreseeable future. But in some blue states that want this thing to work, inch by inch, things really are starting to look up in very, very concrete ways. How does that change our country in the long run?